Just about wherever you live, along with spring season comes that yard work. Planting, pruning, digging, mowing. You own a garden, the work seems endless. Do I even need to mention the pain and strain on your body and back? You know what I'm talking about. Some of it can be severe enough that it can prevent you from enjoying your life after. That is why we are going to pay Dr. James Garrett a visit. He'll show you how to stay safe and injury-free so you can actually enjoy the benefits of your beautiful yard when all the work is said and done. So why don't we connect with him now?
Safe gardening. Come on, it's not bungee jumping. Look, we want to have some fun. We want to be able to do it in the future. We want to get to where our body can participate and not be a spectator in making sure our garden looks nice. So as we do the different maneuvers, we want to get our body ready. We want to prepare just like any other exercise. So we want to get to where we're warming up, we're stretching, we're advancing our body to the place where it's now ready to do the different types of maneuvers. So as we stretch, you know, there's probably many stretches we've talked about on this show before, but some of them are going to be like the best friend hug where you're grabbing yourself and you're turning and making sure you get that body. We're going to hold that around 10 seconds. And then obviously we want to do both sides. We want to, you know, it's a, like any sport, it's usually going to be both sides are going to be involved. So another stretch that we can do to keep ourselves safeguarded is really the back of the leg. So as we put our foot up on a stool or a bench, and then we're going to bend our body forward in order to feel, you know, the stretch back there. And remember, we don't want to hurt ourselves. We want to go really light and easy. If you haven't done it in a while, you just really take your time at it. You know, another stretch would be the, you know, getting the front of your leg as well. You're going to be using that a lot in the different gardening. And so we're going to just reach and grab our ankle, and we'll pull it up. And again, we're going to hold that for about 15 seconds. We'll do two or three of those each side and make sure it doesn't hurt all along the way. Remember, the stretches are just a few just to get us going. We want to make sure you're stretching your whole body so you're ready to really safe garden appropriately. Now, shoveling is the first place we're going to start. We want to make sure that you're aligned. It's going to burn some calories. It's a lot of fun. It's going to be active. And let me show you a few techniques so that we can really make sure we're shoveling properly. Lean your body weight forward onto the shovel. Let the weight of your body sink into the shovel in the ground. Notice how you keep your spine in line. So to begin lifting the dirt, you want to shift your weight on your back leg. Use the gliding motion of the pelvis. Make sure you bend your knees at the hips and not the back. We want to leverage the shovel out of the ground by bending the knees, especially in the back one, to lower your body down more. By lowering your body down more, when you lift the shovel up, you're positioning the center of your weight and harnessing the power of your pelvis, your hips, and your legs rather than your back. So instead of taking that dirt and flinging it over your shoulder, just turn the shovel handle, let the dirt fall. We always want to make sure we're using the hips and knees to avoid putting extra strain on the back. Now that wasn't so hard, was it? Now let's get to those pesky weeds. So weeding. You can put a lot of stress on your back. And many times we don't really know that we have that stress until we pick up that one weed and their back goes out. So some of the techniques that we can use is get a bucket and sit on that. It helps us bend our knees. You can use a stool. Some stools are actually have wheels on them so you can wheel around with that to take that extra stress off your back. From the wheelbarrow to the bags of soil, the fertilizer, all of this, it just requires lifting. We've all heard, don't lift with your back. You know, bend your knees when you're lifting. It's just a really important process to understand that if something's too heavy, don't lift it. Ask for help. Get somebody else to help you out. We have plenty of neighbors that can help you lift, or even your own family. All right, so speaking of lifting, now we've created some dirt. Let's pick it up and let's bring out the wheelbarrow. Now we want to make sure the wheelbarrow is helping us, not hurting us. So I'm going to give you a few tips on how to use it correctly. We need to bend the knees. So we need to make sure we get the proper grip. We need to make sure that our spine is aligned and avoid twisting. So the key here is really using the whole body so that we don't injure the back. So think of a beautiful lawn, and with that beautiful lawn comes maintenance or mowing of the lawn to keep it beautiful. Sometimes the first part of that is what they call in physics inertia. It's just that momentum to get the lawnmower moving, and sometimes that's where we can first start to have some troubles. So as we get our wrists in the proper neutral position, we want to use our body as leverage to move the lawnmower across the lawn. We don't want to bend the back. We want to keep it straight. We want to use all these different techniques to prevent injury so we can enjoy the lawn after. So let's talk power tools. Power tools can really be a time saver, but they can also take a toll on your back. Most of them come with a strap. As we're wearing that, it helps distribute the weight evenly throughout our body, and it helps keep a center of gravity, which is critical when we're using this for long terms, because one of the tips is we want to make sure that we're switching sides with this power tool. We want to get to where one side is not overworked versus the other side. Another tip as we progress along too is that if you're getting tired, the tiredness can actually get you set up for an injury. So that's real important that we recognize our fatigue factor. So in conclusion, just wanted to leave you with some last tips. Really watch your posture. Stay balanced as much as you can. Drink plenty of water. And if you are experiencing any pain, definitely talk to your chiropractor. Want to handle things when they're small rather than waiting until they become big. And that will just ensure that you have a great gardening experience.